StreamYard is an amazing live streaming application. It's got so many great features like displaying comments, sharing your screen, inviting guests to be part of your stream, just to name a few. But there are also some other really cool features that are not quite so obvious. So I like to say they're hidden, but not quite hidden features. And today I'm going to share five of these amazing little features that you may not be aware of. Hey, what's going on, everybody? My name's Mel, and I am super stoked about this video today because sometimes all you have to do is poke around a little bit to discover some really cool features of different applications or software that you are using. And today, I'm excited to share with you five of these features that I have found in StreamYard that are just not as obvious, but pretty amazing. In fact, the fifth one that I'm gonna show you might allow you to eliminate another application that you're already paying for. But before we get started, as always, don't forget to make sure that you are subscribed to this channel, as well as click on that notification bell so that you don't miss any of our uploads, as well as our live shows that we produce. Okay, the very first tip that I want to share with you as far as the hidden features go is that you can actually upload an animated GIF file into the logo section inside of your studio. So if you're on one of our paid plans, you already know that you can customize your stream by adding your own logo, which will be displayed in the upper right-hand corner of your stream. You can turn this on and off, of course, at any time, but you may not have realized that you can also upload an animated GIF file. So there are a few ways that you might want to utilize this feature. You could actually upload a little countdown timer up to 60 seconds for or maybe a rapid fire Q&A, or even just a little contest or a game that you might be playing. But you could also upload an animated logo to just add a little extra flair to your live stream video. Okay, so this next feature is kind of a doozy, so hang on tight, but it's awesome. So you maybe have seen people go live and they will switch different camera angles. So I've got this camera angle, maybe you see somebody switch to like a behind the scenes camera angle. This is actually typically done with a piece of hardware known as maybe a switcher that they literally are selecting different cameras, or a third party application that they have connected to their live video streaming software. However, you can also do this without any of that stuff using StreamYard. So you actually simply will just open a second browser window, enter the studio, and select your other camera. Let me show you really quickly how this is done. Okay, so here we are inside of the StreamYard studio. And as you can see, I am up on screen and I'm gonna now add a second camera. Now, obviously you need to have another camera hooked up to your computer. You could of course use an old camera, or if you just have a second webcam, you could also use your iPhone or your phone as a webcam. And we have a video about that, of course. So make sure you check that out. So we're simply going to open another StreamYard tab. So we're gonna open up StreamYard once again. We're gonna enter the same broadcast studio. It's gonna open us up, and we're gonna, here we are, we have an option to select our camera. Now, I'm gonna change my name even to Behind the Scenes, and I'm gonna select my old Logitech 920. That I have propped up behind me, set up as a behind the scenes camera. Now, the other thing that's very critical are your audio settings. You wanna make sure that when you enter the studio, you are all gonna enter it with your mic on mute, or you're gonna get feedback. The other thing that's really critical is that you use a speaker that is either inactive or turned all the way down, because when you enter the studio, you're gonna have some volume issues going on and some echo. So we're gonna mute our microphone. I'm gonna go over here, and I'm gonna turn off my speaker. Now I'm able to mute my computer, so I'm using the computer speaker, so you wanna mute those. Now this works if you're using this as a behind the scenes camera. So we're gonna enter the broadcast studio, and I'm gonna, now you see that I'm actually in the studio still, but my main control is now switched. So I'm gonna go back over to the initial tab that I had open, because that's my main source. And I'm just gonna simply add to the stream, and here you are. You now have both cameras in the stream. Now what's really, really cool is you can toggle back and forth just like you do with a guest. So I can simply select solo layout, and I am behind the scenes, showing you my behind the scenes. I can then go straight over here. I can simply just click around and change the look and feel of this broadcast. So you may be like, well, why would I do this? It actually is gonna be great. People love a good behind the scenes. I like using alternating camera angles, especially when I'm kind of getting my audience warmed up, but also people ask me about my setup often. And so I like to show them a little behind the scenes when I reference something. Now you can obviously use all of the really cool different views in StreamYard and switch around, again, just like you do when you have a guest. This is just a simple way for you to add that extra camera angle to, again, add a little more pizzazz to your live videos. pretty cool, right? I mean, who knew? Who knew? So here's the deal. It is going to depend on the power of your computer and your internet speed, but it is possible that there could be a little bit of a lag on that second camera or third camera, depending on what you do, and maybe a little pixelation. It is going to depend on the power of your computer and, again, your internet speed. So be sure to test this out before you fully go all in and implement it into your live video. All right, here we are at feature number three. Now, I like to call this one the voice of Oz. You know, like in the movie The Wizard of Oz, when the wizard is talking and no one can see where he is, but he's really just behind a big curtain and he's hiding and he's making it sound like he's this almighty powerful thing and it's just his voice everywhere. It's kind of like the same thing, but a little bit different. Okay, now to get this to work, all you have to do is when you are in your studio, of course, before you go live, you can also adjust this while you're live, is you're gonna go right over here to your settings. These are your general settings overall. So you're gonna select that. And then in your general settings here, you're gonna make sure that you have unchecked audio avatars. Now, when you have this checked and you turn off your camera, you will actually see a picture and it will vibrate as you talk. This is really cool, but maybe you don't want that particular thing to happen. If you deselect this and we go back to our studio, and if I turn off my camera, I am actually still able to talk. My audience is still gonna be able to hear me, and we can see right here it's letting us know that our audio is still on. Now, this of course is you're gonna wanna have a background selected, because when you turn off your camera, it is going to show whatever's in the background. So if you just have your generic background, that's fine, but maybe think about uploading a picture that you would wanna use if you're gonna go with this. Now, why would you do this? Maybe you wanna do a live interview for a podcast, but you don't necessarily wanna be on camera, or your guest doesn't wanna be on camera. The other thing is maybe you are sharing your screen or you're sharing some slides and you just simply wanna make sure that you're not accidentally gonna appear on camera. The other reason that this might be a thing that you might wanna use is if you are maybe producing a show and other people are the talent, and every once in a while you might need to come on and speak and say something, but again, you simply don't want to be on screen with your face and your video. So this is a really cool feature, as again, we call the voice of Oz, because you can't see the person, but you can hear them in the stream. Okay, we're moving on to hidden feature number four. Now this one really is kind of hidden. I actually discovered this by accident when one of my friends was streaming, and she did it by accident. The space bar is actually like a hotkey for undo. It's an undo button. It really is. Go try it, but I'm gonna show you right now. Okay, here we are in the studio. Now, I'm not live, but I can definitely show you how this works. So let's say that you have all these comments coming in and you're ready to display a comment, which of course StreamYard makes this super easy. You will obviously click on that comment to display it. Now, you may then at that point take your hand off your mouse, start moving around, and you don't wanna fumble around and look down for your mouse. And if comments are still coming, then your mouse is no longer hovered over that original comment. So obviously, if you select the mouse button again on that comment, it will go away. Or you can just hit the space bar and it goes away. Now, it is an undo button, so if you hit the space bar again, it will redisplay that comment, because it's gonna undo undisplaying the comment. Undo undisplaying. That's okay, right? So here's the thing. It does not work if you navigate away from where you are. So if I have the comment displayed and then I go over to my banners, for example, and I hit spacebar, it does not do anything at that point. So keep that in mind, but it also works for banners. So if I have a banner up and I'm talking and yada yada and I'm ready to take it down, but I don't wanna take my eyes off of the camera, because as we know, looking into the lens is looking into the eyes of your audience, then all I have to do is hit that spacebar, which I can feel that spacebar super easy because it's right there in front of me. So the spacebar is your undo button. That is hidden feature number four. That one might be my favorite. I'm really not sure. I love all of these hidden features, but hidden feature number five. So this one might actually allow you to eliminate a paid subscription to a virtual meeting software, because you can also use the StreamYard Studio to host virtual meetings. So you can actually create a demo broadcast or a dummy broadcast, never go live, and use StreamYard to invite your guests to join that studio. Now, like many of the virtual meeting software, you can share your screen. There's even a little chat box that you have. You can do all the same things with StreamYard and use all the fun features like the banners and other stuff. You can even choose to record your virtual meeting as well without ever going live. So one of the things I love about StreamYard is you're not limited to the duration of your meeting. So with many of the paid virtual software for virtual meetings is you actually have to pay to go past a certain time limit. You don't have to do that with StreamYard. So on our free plan, you can have up to 6 participants in your meeting for as long as you want. And of course, on our paid plans, you can have up to 10 participants in your meeting, and your participants can share their screens, you can share your screen, you can bring them up on stage, remove them, and customize the look and feel of your virtual meeting. So that might be something you never thought about that StreamYard will allow you to do. So I wanted to make sure you were aware of that in case you're using another software and you're paying for it for virtual meetings. There you go. Those are five hidden, kind of not so hidden features in StreamYard that maybe you didn't know about before. What hidden features have you discovered outside of these five that I just shared with you? Here's the deal. Using these applications is like exploring. It's like a treasure hunt. You can find different use cases. So what are some maybe not so obvious ways that you're using StreamYard that maybe others aren't aware of? I would love to know in the comments. So let us know how you're using StreamYard in unique ways, as well as maybe some hidden but not so hidden features that you've discovered along the way. Now, that's what I have for today. Now, as always, make sure you are subscribed and click on that notification bell so you don't miss any of the other videos that we upload and, of course, when we go live. All right, see you later. Thank you.